Rolling.
Okay, he said we're rolling.
All right, we're on.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey there, I'm Joe.
And I'm Justin.
We're the Okee Dokee Brothers, and we'll be your narrators today.
Yeah, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the story. Oh, and when you hear the banjo, that's a little hint to turn the page.
Okay, sounds good. Let's get this thing started. Thousand Star Hotel by the Okee Dokee Brothers.
Hey, that's us. We wrote a book?
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, we wrote a book.
Illustrations by Brandon Reese.
I love that guy's drawings.
Published by Sterling Children's Books. There were once two river rats.
Muskrats, to be exact.
Who lived in a cabin near a big old river.
Sheltered by a willow tree, the cabin had cracked walls, and most of the roof had been lost in a storm.
Despite the cabin's imperfections, Mr. and Mrs. Muskrat still called it home.
Every morning after a breakfast of leftover soup, the river rats walked to the river to catch some fish. Mr. Muskrat always declared,
I'm sick and tired of this same old soup. Today's the day we catch enough fish to make us rich.
Mrs. Muskrat would smile and reply,
Well, I'll be happy if we catch enough fish for supper. That's all we'd need.
Each evening, the river rats came home with just enough fish to cook that night. Nothing more.
One day, Mr. Muskrat felt a strong tug on his fishing line.
Whoa, jumpin' Jiminy!
He shouted,
I've never felt a fish pull like this. I bet it's the lunker we've been waiting for.
After much struggling, tuggling, yanking, and cranking, they managed to catch a giant golden catfish whose scales shimmered like stars. It burst out of the water and swam up to their boat, peering at the river rats through big, bulging eyes. The fish spoke.
Oh boy. Kind and gentle river rats, show mercy, for I am a fish of great magic, and if you release me, I will grant you a wish.
Mr. Muskrat was too dumbfounded to speak.
A wish?
Said Mrs. Muskrat.
Oh, let's see. Oh, a hammer and some nails to fix up our roof is all we'd really need.
Mr. Muskrat instantly found his voice.
Hammer? Nails? You gotta be kidding. This is our chance.
He looked at the fish and yelled,
We wish to live in a big, fancy house with a proper roof.
The fish flipped its tail once, then spoke.
Ripples and rushes, gusts and gushes. A fish has been fished, and a wish has been...
Wait! Just one river stinking minute. I changed my mind. Surely we can wish for something better than a plain old house.
Better?
Mrs. Muskrat scratched her head.
Well, I don't know about that, but we could use a new soup kettle. Ours is worn out and starting to leak, but that's all we'd ever need.
Mr. Muskrat frowned. He didn't want to settle for a kettle. He wanted a life of luxury.
We wish to live in the biggest and best mansion on the river.
Again, the fish's tail flipped, and it spoke.
Okay, here we go. Ripples and rushes, gusts and gushes, a fish has been fished, and a wish has been...
Hold your fish feathers! We can't waste this wish. Let's think of something even bigger than a mansion.
Bigger?
Said Mrs. Muskrat.
Why don't we wish for a nice, warm quilt? That's truly all we'd ever need.
You're thinking too small. A 5-star hotel is what we want. Imagine housekeeping, room service, and big fluffy pillows on a king-sized bed.
Mrs. Muskrat sighed.
Oh, 5-star, 10-star. You could have a 1,000-star hotel and you'd still want more.
Mr. Muskrat threw his arms around his wife and exclaimed,
Jumpin' Jiminy, you're brilliant! We wish to live in a 1,000-star hotel!
Mrs. Muskrat opened her mouth to protest, but she was interrupted by a flip of the tail and the familiar rhyme.
Okay, for real this time. Ripples and rushes.
Gusts and gushes. A fish has been fished, and a wish has been
wished.
And with that, the fish splashed into the river. A glimmer of gold sparkled below the surface and disappeared into the light of the setting sun.
Mrs. Muskrat gathered their things while Mr. Muskrat bounced ahead of his wife.
Just leave that stuff behind! Our troubled fishing days are over!
Heading home through the last light of day, a strong gust of wind came from behind them. It shook the oak trees and ripped through the willows. Mrs. Muskrat looked concerned, but Mr. Muskrat had his mind on ordering dinner from his 1,000-star room service.
I think I'll get the fish tartare.
The couple reached the grove at the end of the trail, but they didn't see a hotel. At the bottom of the hill, as usual, stood the muskrat's cabin, with its cracked walls and crumbling roof. The only difference was that the old willow tree had been blown down by the wind.
Mr. Muskrat threw his hat to the ground. He kicked at the dirt and pulled at his hair.
That lying cheat of a talking fish! There's no magic! This is our old cabin, as weather-beaten and ramshackled as ever. We should have taken that fish into town and sold it.
One moment, dear. You should come see this,
Mrs. Muskrat called from inside the cabin.
Mr. Muskrat walked inside. His wife smiled at him and pointed up through the wide hole in the roof. He tipped his head back and gasped. Without the large willow hanging over the cabin, he now had a perfect view of the night sky and its thousands of twinkling stars.
Jumpin' Jiminy, would you look at that?
Mr. Muskrat marveled.
They're beautiful.
Mrs. Muskrat put a hand on her husband's shoulder and said,
It looks like your wish really did come true.
And you know,
Mr. Muskrat said,
This is all we ever needed.
That evening, the two river rats fell asleep while stargazing in their 1,000-star hotel.
And they lived simply ever after.
The end.
Well, there you have it.
All right.
Hope you enjoyed the story.
Yeah, thanks for reading along, and we'll see you next time.
Well, hey, that wasn't so bad, was it?
Yeah, not bad, not bad.
I kind of liked it.
That's a good story.
Should do it again sometime.
Okay, let's go write another.